Researchers at the University of Chicago, in a retrospective study of patients who were tested for COVID-19, found an association between vitamin D deficiency and the likelihood of becoming infected with the coronavirus. Joining us now to talk about these important findings is Dr. David Meltzer, Chief of Hospital Medicine at University of Chicago and lead author of the study. Welcome, Dr. Meltzer. Good to have you here. So listen, break it down for us. How does vitamin D help our overall health?
So vitamin D is a hormone that is produced naturally in the skin when exposed to sunlight and then modified a bit in the liver and kidneys. And it does several things, many, many different functions. Some of the most important people know about are affecting bone health. But less well appreciated but important right now is the fact that vitamin D also helps enhance the immune system.
What did you learn about the patients in your study who were vitamin D deficient?
What we discovered is that patients who were vitamin D deficient were about 77% more likely to test positive for COVID than patients who weren't vitamin D deficient.
That's a big number, 77%?
It's a big number, and it was impressive to us when we saw it. But it wasn't totally unexpected might happen. As I mentioned, there's good data that vitamin D helps the immune system, several parts of it. And then we knew of a study done a number of years ago that combined a bunch of other studies that showed that patients who were vitamin D deficient and were randomly assigned to get vitamin D had about a 70% lower incidence of viral respiratory tract infections in general. And we knew that some of those respiratory tract infections were probably some type of coronavirus, not this type, but some type, and wondered, well, maybe this would make a difference here too.
Wow, that's great information. Let me ask you a question. People have to understand that sunlight helps us make the vitamin D, but our dermatologists and our friends in dermatology say, hey, be careful of too much sunlight. How do we get people to understand the balance?
If you can get some skin exposure on a regular basis, some people say as little as 15 or 30 minutes a day without burning, that can really help. Now, one challenge is that most sunscreens block out the part of light that you actually need to make vitamin D. So if you're going to go out and be out in the sun for a ton, I'd still wear sunscreen. But if you're going to go out and be there for a short period of time on a regular basis, which I think is a great idea for people if you can do it in your climate, then I think skipping the sunscreen for that brief exposure is probably a very reasonable thing to do.
That's really important. So about 15 to 30 minutes every day if you can. But if you're going out there longer, of course, you want to block some of those sun rays. And vitamin D is also very affordable. You know, it's not expensive. It's easy to get. How does that help with these findings?
Yeah, for sure. It really is affordable for many people. Now, one thing to be careful with supplements is that you can't take too much. The recommended daily allowance for vitamin D for most people is about 600 to 800 international units per day. The National Academy of Medicine has said it's safe for most people to take up to about 4,000 units a day. But the higher the dose gets, the bigger the risk of high calcium, which can cause fatigue and frequent urination and weakness and falls and other things. So you can go too high on this. But the good news is that they're readily available, inexpensive, safe doses, you know, from the range of 400 units a day up to about 4,000 units a day. And for the vast majority of us, that's the very, very safe.
Well, Dr. Meltzer from the University of Chicago, thank you so much. You know, it's important, particularly for African Americans who tend to be at higher risk of vitamin D deficiency. So looking at something that could help boost the immune system is very important. Thank you.
Agreed. Thank you. Thanks for having me.